Even though The Incredibles is 14 years old, there's some really cool science and technology wrapped up in that film. So in this week's video, I'm going to look at some of that technology and see whether it exists here in real life. Welcome to Science with Steph, the show where I think way too much about the world around us and then share the best bits with you guys. I don't know about you, but The Incredibles is in my top three Pixar films of all time. It is solid gold from start to finish, and one of the coolest things about it is all the cool spy tech and gadgetry. One of the first really cool pieces of technology we see is actually in a scene set 15 years before the bulk of the movie, and that's Mr. Incredible's self-driving car. Now, about 14 years after the first film came out, some big companies are trialling and testing their first ever driverless cars. They're all being hailed as the next big thing. They're really driving innovation. Honk your horn if you like driverless cars. No. However, the first tests have shown that driverless cars aren't quite ready for the variability in human activity yet, or to work in all weather conditions. And it becomes particularly difficult when either the safety of the passenger or other drivers is compromised. I don't think we'll be seeing high-speed robbery chases in driverless cars anytime soon. So jumping to present day in the Incredibles universe, one of the first really cool pieces of tech we see is the Omnidroid. The first time we see Mr. Incredible fight this artificially intelligent machine, we see the Omnidroid learning as it's fighting him. Now, artificial intelligence has really boomed in the past 15 years, especially with the development of Google's deep learning algorithm that can now recognize cats off of unlabeled YouTube videos. I mean, a course machine taught from the internet learns how to recognize cats, first of all. Oh, cutie, cutie, cutie. There are also neural networks that can mimic human creativity by making art, writing music, literature, or even winning chess matches. The way neural networks and artificial intelligence works is by feeding it lots and lots of data to learn from, whether that's images, books, or music, and then weighting the decision that the computer makes at every single point to try and get to the desired outcome. The machine will then be able to make smart decisions based on the next set of data. This isn't so much seen in the case of The Incredibles, where that big Omnidroid sees Syndrome use that remote once and then instantly makes that decision to destroy the remote. Even our most advanced computers wouldn't come to that decision based on one data point. Another very cool piece of tech are the scanners and drones.
Terminated.
Drones, again, are one of these technologies that have only really become commercial in the past 10 years or so. Big companies are using drones to deliver packages, in filming interesting shots in movies, and in scanning things remotely in difficult places that humans can't get to. So could a little drone like this really do a light scan and detect life forms? Well, this technology is apparently using light detection. We currently do have devices which detect movement using light. They're called LiDAR. And the way that they work is they shoot out beams of light that hit off moving particles, and when that light's reflected back into the machine, it can work out how fast that particle is moving because of the wavelength of the light. The technology is a little bit like radar police scanners, but instead of using radio waves, you're using light waves. So I reckon you could probably see a billionaire owning a very miniaturized drone version. Some of the coolest tech in this film though is made by the best side character in any Pixar film.
Edna Mode.
She creates whole new superhero outfits with really cool properties, like they can withstand 1,000 degrees temperature, virtually indestructible, can stretch as far as Elastigirl can go invisible, reduce friction.
And machine washable, darling, that's a new feature.
Is there such a material with so many cool properties? Well, material science has come a long way since 2004. The first iPhone with a full touchscreen actually came out 3 years after The Incredibles. Man, that film came out a long time ago. Since then, not only have touchscreens become much more commonplace, but they can also be manufactured in really high volumes. They're much more durable, much more sensitive, can work under glass. All sorts of advancements have been made. But the most exciting material to be invented is actually graphene. Now, you've probably heard of graphene before. It is a lattice of carbon atoms with only one atom thick. It seemed to be 200 times stronger than steel, it's superconductive, it's flexible, it could help develop amazing new headphones, new supercomputers. It's basically a magic material. The first ever graphene was actually invented the year The Incredibles came out, and a lot of the science has gone into trying to make this stuff on a large scale since then. So no, unfortunately, we can't make an entire super suit out of material that's flexible, virtually indestructible, and machine washable. Okay, so can I do one more gadget?
I've still got time.
So you know that tractopine that Syndrome uses to freeze the supers? Well, scientists at Glasgow Uni can actually move particles around using a light beam. They're called optical pincers. This only happens on an atomic scale, but the applications in medicine, computing, and material science are massive. There we have it. Five cool technologies from a film made 14 years ago where the science is still catching up. What are your favourite things from The Incredibles, and what are your thoughts on the sequel? Leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Science with Steph. If you have any suggestions, comments, or science related questions, leave them in the comment section down below. I bring out new videos every Friday, so if you want to see my last video, you can click here. Or if you enjoyed this content and would like to subscribe, please click here. Until next time, bye! Got my key in ignition, hot and fresh off the kitchen. Self-drive activated.